Hey Cancer, Sun, Moon, Horizon, welcome to Live, Laugh, Love, Tarot. Today we're delving into your energy and your person's energy. This is the person that you have on your mind at the current moment, okay? This can play out past, present, or future. Take it how it resonates, if it resonates for you. This is a timeless reading, so when you're seeing it, that's when it's meant for you, okay? You can always check out my playlist for additional collective reads. I have personals available, link down below in the description box. You will only ever book a personal with me through my website, okay? And I want to thank you all so much for all of the likes, subscribes, tips, donations, bookings to this channel. It is all greatly appreciated. Let's delve into Cancer's energy right now, please and thank you, Spirit. What's Cancer's energy? You're walking away from a situation that no longer serves you emotionally. Yeah, that's what I'm seeing. I don't know. Spirit keeps wanting me to talk about how I broke my nail, right? It's like a little crack on the side, right? And then it grows more and more and more. There could have been something in this relationship. Smash that like button if this is you, okay? Where you saw little holes and cracks in your relationship with this person until you just had to walk away emotionally. I feel like something was emotionally draining for you, Cancer, all right? Yeah, and now you're ready to drop that burden, all right? You're dropping a burden. You're not dealing with this. It's like the things that you had to offer to this person, your love language, it just wasn't enough, okay? Yeah, you felt at one moment in time you were starting to be toxic, like you weren't taking care of yourself. You were starting to get vengeful. Like, and you like, you was acting out of character. I'm getting like you're a very faithful person. But this person, when they acted like this, smash that like button if this is you. When this person acted unappreciative of the way that you expressed your love, okay, the way that you showed this person that you love them, you know, and things like that, nothing was good enough. You're walking away from that. You hate the way that it made you feel. It made you feel like going to go dog this person out. Smash that like button if that's you. And you're like, you know what? I don't like this. This is not who I am, okay? You have a lot of fire in you, a lot of passion in you. Okay, you could have Leo highly aspected in places in your chart. Okay, you could be a Cancer sun Leo moon, or you could be a Leo sun Cancer moon. Okay, it's something like that where I see Leo and Cancer highly aspected in places in your chart. Okay, here we have that Knight of Wands energy. I can't make it up. It's making you feel like unappreciated and fuck it. I'm just going to go sleep with somebody else. I'm going to go get that love from somewhere else to the point where it just feels like, you know what? Fuck this whole thing. If I'm not happy somewhere, then let it go. What's for me will be for me. Yeah, and that's where you begin to set those healthy boundaries. Because you're like, this ain't even who I want to be right now. It's like the dating game right now is trash. You know, you're like, I'm not finna just be out here because this person got me angry. You're somebody that's very in control of your emotions, okay? That's what I'm seeing with the King of Swords. Very intellectual, very fucking smart, and you learn from your mistakes, whether you're a male or a female. Okay, you're going to be very vocal with this person and you're like, look, it's not working out. I'm not happy, you know, in this situation and I'm moving forward. I'm moving towards something that's more for me, you know, because my person has to be out there and I'm willing to win at any fucking cost. If that means just walking away from you, okay? I see you making a decision here. Ooh, Knight of Cups. Are you going towards someone? I'm not getting, normally Knight of Cups would give me like, you going to someone from your past to fix things and give. But this is more so like you're returning back. It's like you had this wish fulfillment of a person that ticks all boxes for you. Okay, you're a perfect person or just wish fulfillment. What would make you happy? And it's like you're returning to that again. You're going to put time, effort, and energy into that again. I see you moving towards that. Okay, for sure. Moving away from this energy of I'm going to get back at someone, okay? And more so, I'm going to get back to me, back to the basics, all right? So smash that like button if that's you. Let's go ahead and delve into the person's energy, your person. What's your person's energy? the high priestess. This person knows something and they're not speaking about it. This person knows that you maybe want to leave them, that you're getting ready to leave them. Okay. With the Knight of Swords, here you come coming in and you're saying something to this person. But it's like they're already anticipating you to. With the Ten of Cups here, this person is like, well, I thought we were going to have a family. I thought, Three of Cups. Yep. And there's that third party energy. So I'm getting two things. Smash that like button. If you're like, damn, I just can't decide between the old person and the new person who is going to be my person for this read. Smash that like button if that's you, Cancer, because I'm getting the energy of two people. The person that you're going towards, the person that's wish fulfillment for you, this person is very intuitive themselves, okay? And they know, they can feel that something is coming towards them. They know that it's possibly you. It may be even the fact that this person knows that it's you, okay? And that you're dealing with someone else. See, this person feels like you're dealing with someone else, okay? But intuitively, they know that you're coming towards them to have a family. Okay, for emotional happiness, and that indeed you are their happiness as well, coming together as this family dynamic, I see. And then the person that is in the past, the one that you're leaving, they know that you're coming to break up with them. It's like you all had this happy home, the way that they view it. You could have been with this person for a little while, or you could have talked about expansion of a family, getting married, things like that. And now they're like, well, you're acting different. Is it someone else? You know, they can tell that you're not happy, especially with this King of Wands in reverse. The bottom deck is the Six of Wands for this person. They want to come out victorious with the Queen of Cups. They want you to still want them. I'm hearing, I want you to want me. I want you to need me with the Strength card here. This person is still trying to hold on. They're still trying to, in hopes that y'all can get back together. They're having strength to try to come out victorious in this spat that you're having. But with the Princess of Wands, you're telling this person straight up, it's not working. I'm breaking up with you. It's not you, it's me. With the Three of Wands here, it's like, I don't know, you're telling this person, okay? Smash that like button if you've already told this person this, or you're revving up to tell them this. It's not you, it's me. I'm anticipating more. I want more out of love, out of relationships. It's like you're speaking this to this person. Let me see what just fell on the floor. Oh, Princess of Swords in reverse. It's like, I'm tired of studying, trying to figure out what you want, what you don't want. It's like, I'm burning myself out and I refuse to do that for you. You're making me get out of character. With the Nine of Cups, I don't want to do that. I want to go towards things that are fulfilling for me. And it's to the point where you're pulling me out of my character here. With the Seven of Wands, now you have boundaries set up for this person. Yeah, with the Six of Wands, this person is being victorious with not telling you what they know for sure. With the Three of Cups energy here, it's like they know that they're probably anticipating you coming in, telling them that that you're leaving them for someone else. Because it's like they see or they sense it. With the Lovers here, this person knows your heart is somewhere else. I'm going to tell you that. And with the Five of Wands here, this person really could be, like I said, willing to fight for their spot, willing to compete, okay? And they're like, well, I should come out on top anyway because I pulled this person once before, I can pull them again. Yeah, Ten of Cups. But then if we look at it as if this is your other person, the one you're going towards, there's almost an energy here of you're tired of studying this situation. You're about to go in for what you know. There could be some moment where you're kind of stagnant when it comes to this person. You're stagnant to the point where it's like you have a moment like, well, should I actually, is this okay? Yes, follow your heart. Don't, you know what I'm saying? And I see you doing just that. You having some type of boundary, but at the same time, this person knowing that they're going to let you come in when you come in. Okay, they know that you have someone else, but they feel like you're going to choose them, that you're going to fight for them, and you're going to show them that this is what you really want. And I feel as though when you do this, this person is going to submit. With the Knight of Pentacles here, a lot of planning You thought about this long and hard before you pushed forward towards breaking up with this person. With the Five of Swords, when it dawned on you, you're like, look, I'm not holding back from my happiness any longer. What's for me is just going to fucking be for me. With the Five of Cups, you're like, look, I don't care if I got to be on the outside if this person is not going to talk to me again. I don't care if this, you know, I'm outcasted by this person. I got to do what's best for me. And then there it is, the Death card. You ending a situation, okay? And it's almost like this person knows that you're going to end a situation and go with someone else. They're going to put up a fight, but ultimately you're going to smash that shit down because you're like, I know what it is that I want. And then we have the Six of Cups. For a lot of you, you're moving towards this past memory of love or what love looked like for you. And you're finding it in someone that you're moving towards, okay, that you're moving forward with. And for those of you all that this is a past person that you're breaking up with, you're dead in that. That's what it's saying with the Death card and the Six of Cups. You could have been dealing with a water sign as well, like a Scorpio, okay, or a Pisces or a Cancer as yourself. But here we have that Six of Swords, moving to calmer waters, okay, healing, moving away, giving space, okay. Yeah, Queen of Pentacles. You could be moving towards an earth sign. This person is very abundant, okay? You're moving towards someone that is very abundant, somebody that is very stable. They could already have children, okay? But you may like the way that this person is submissive to you. That's what I'm seeing, okay, Cancer? You want me to be honest? You're moving towards someone that is more submissive towards you. And this person shows you that they appreciate you. And this person is nurturing. They are a parent. They wear many hats. Okay. But this person, their feminine energy is on fleek. Okay. But the Eight of Pentacles, you may like what this person does for work. This person may make a lot of money. They may be able to take care of themselves. Okay. That may be something that you were moving away from with this past person. They could have been showing signs of codependency. Yeah, with the Five of Pentacles, this person may be acting out, the past person, like, you know, I'm so sad, I'm depressed. How could you do this to me? Like playing the blame game, you know? But at the end of the day, you have to go towards what makes you happy. It very well could be a Leo, okay? Or earth sign. I'm seeing that. Sun, Moon, or Rising. Here we have the Two of Wands, that decision being made at the end of the day. After a moment with a Hangman of stagnancy, you figuring out, making the next move, your best move, but you're going towards an Empress. Point blank, period. This person could be a Libra. The one that you're going towards, that is your soulmate. Could be a Libra, could be a Leo, could have that somewhere in their chart. With the Hermit energy here, I see you really pulling back, having that retrospect, looking within, okay? And you're looking at these toxicities. Like I said, it comes back up again. You're looking at these toxicities, that how this person from your past that you're moving away from, how they took you out of character and you didn't like that shit. You're getting back to yourself, okay? And quite frankly, you could have been obsessing over that. How can I manifest my way out of this fucking situation? That's what I'm seeing for you. I gotta be honest. Let's see your energy moving forward. The Runner. Runner in a codependent relationship. Fear of intimacy, listening to ego. You were running away from this person. This past person, for sure you was. Because they were codependent. Yeah, watching, looking, stalking, gaslighting, focusing out. This person was smothering you. Yeah, love call. Someone expresses love. It's like they on your ass and you need a breather, okay? Or they're doing this and then they're like, well, why are you not liking this? Why are you da-da-da-da? It could have been that this person was saying that you were too clingy on them, okay? And they were running away from you as you were trying to love on their ass. And that really brought you out of character. You like, damn, this is pissing me off. They won't take my love language. You know, they don't understand me. So after a while, you get burned out and you leave. Your person, your past person, let's do that. Outdated thinking, conditioning, replaying events over and over in your head. This person, they're just going to stay stagnant. They're going to replay these events over and over and they're going to possibly be depressed. The new person, sword with a stone, clarity, truth, revelation, solidarity, okay? Force, honor, protection, power. They're having clarity. Like, look, okay, this really is my person. Yeah, abundance. This person is fucking abundant. I want to say the person you're moving towards is abundant. But then we have union, marry, soul connection. You have some type of soul tie with this past person. They want to stay connected to you, okay? If you married to this person, they're going to give you a hard time trying to divorce. That's what I see. They're constantly replaying how things once were, or they're replaying that you, it's like, well, you said you was going to marry me. You know? I'm hearing, you said you was going to marry me. When I say that, when you had to lay up. No, but literally that's what I'm hearing. So y'all was laid up and you telling this person that one moment in time, because you're romantic. Smash that like button if you're romantic. And I see you really telling this person, you know, but until it became too fucking much and it drove you out of who you really are as a person, you had to walk away from this. Yeah, reminiscing, keepsake. Making memories, learning from the past, though. You're going forward to make more memories, learning from the past, but this past person is staying in that old energy, okay? Meeting, conversating, savoring the moment, feeling uplifted in friendship. This is you. This is what you're going towards with this new person. And then meeting someone new, a date. You're going to meet up with this person. You're going to go on a date with them. I feel like things are really going to take off. You're very compatible. Okay. That's what I want to say with you and the new person. And I feel like you're going to hit it off very well. Okay. I just want to let you know that this new person is very fucking intuitive. All right. You may have thought that this person from the past was, but this new person very much is, so much that they could feel you when they came in. For sure. They may be a reader. They may be a psychic themselves. All right. That could be another indication, another clue to who this is. So if this message resonated with you, then smash that like button. And if you want to see more reads like this one, smash that like button. Thanks for your love and support to this channel. Until then, peace and love.